everyone, today we are going to learn topological sort using Hann's algorithm. And we are going to do this using BFS, that is depth first search. And we will be using Q data structure because in BFS Q is used. Now let's see what is topological sort. It is a linear ordering of elements, not elements vertices, such that for every directed edge U and V, the vertex U comes before V in the ordering. So it should be a directed acyclic graph. Topological sort is possible only if the graph is directed and acyclic. The graph should be directed. That means it should be pointing to another nodes. And it should be acyclic. That means that it should not contain any cycle. See, this graph does not contain any cycle. So a graph should be directed acyclic graph. We are taking these graphs because a DAG has at least one vertex with in degree 0, which is important in solving the topological sort using Hann's algorithm. We'll see this later. So let's jump into the algorithm. First of all, we have to compute the in degree. To find a topological sort using Hann's algorithm, we have to first compute the in degree of the nodes. And what is in degree? In degree is the incoming edge to the graph. To the node, incoming edge to the node. So see, one is there and there is no in degree to one. No edge is coming to one. So the in degree of one is zero. And for two, one edge is coming to two. So the in degree is one. For three, it is also one. For four, it is two because two incoming edges are there. For five, it's also two. For six, it's one. So we have to compute the in degree, and side by side we can write adjacency list for the nodes in the graph for our reference. We'll use this later. And what is adjacency list? It is a list of adjacent nodes to one particular node. For example, in 1, the adjacent nodes are 2 and 3. For 2, they are 4 and 5 or 5 or 4. We can write in any order. For 3, it is 4, the adjacent node. For 4, it is 5 and 6. For 5, it is 0. 6, it is also 0. We have found out the adjacency list, and then after computing the in degree, we have to pick all the vertices with in degree 0 and then add it into the queue. See, the vertices with in degree 0 is only 1, which is 1. So we'll add it into a queue. We are adding it into a queue and then remove the vertex from the queue. Okay, we'll remove it. And now what we have to do? We have to increment the count of visited nodes by 1. Now 1 is visited. So we will increment the count of the visited nodes. I have taken an array visited. This will store the count of visited nodes. For default condition, all the nodes are unvisited. So I have declared all as 0. Now 1 is visited and we have popped it out from the queue. Then we will increment the count of the visited node 1 by 1. Then what we have to do? We have to decrease the in degree by 1 for all its neighboring nodes. So the neighboring nodes of 1 are 2 and 3, as we can see from adjacency list. Adjacent nodes are neighbor nodes. So we can see it in the adjacency list. They are 2 and 3. So decrease the in degree by 1. We are decreasing the in degree by 1, which becomes 0. And then we'll go back to this step. Remove the vertex from the queue. After decreasing it, and we have to add it into the queue. So we'll add 2 and 3. And then we'll pop it from the queue. And then increment the count in the visited array. 2 and 3 are incremented. Now we'll decrease the in degree of neighboring nodes by 1. The neighboring nodes of 2 and 3 are 4 and 5. 4 is common, so we'll take 4 and 5 and push it into the queue. 4 and 5. And we'll decrement the in degree also. It is 1. But in degree, we have to make the in degree as 0 because we cannot go back to the next step. So we will decrement it so that it becomes 0. Because we have to push the elements. If their in-degree is 0, then only we can push the elements. So till that we will decrease the in-degree. So we are getting the in-degree as 0. So we'll push the 4 and 5 in the queue, and then we'll pop it from the queue and then increment the count in the visited array. 4 and 5 are visited. Now the adjacent nodes of 4 and 5. 4, 5 and 6. The adjacency list. It says 4 and 5 are the adjacent nodes, but 5 is visited. So we'll write 6. First of all, we'll decrement the count of the in-degree. We'll decrease the in-degree by 1 and then we'll add it into the queue. If the in-degree is 0, so it is 0, then we will add it into the queue. Okay, then we will remove it from the queue. After reaching this step, we'll go back to this step. We are removing it and then we are increasing the visited nodes count by 1. So if the count of visited nodes is not equal to the number of nodes, then the graph is not a topological, like we cannot perform topological sort on that graph. It might be a cyclic graph if it is not able to perform a topological sorting. But what are the nodes of the graph? From 1 to 6, that are 6 nodes. And we have traversed all the nodes, that is 6. So it is a topological, like we can perform topological sort in this graph. So no need to check for cycle. Now this is the order in which we have performed the operations. First one, we are incrementing 1, then 2, like in this order, increasing order. So the answer is from 1 to 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 is the answer of the topological sort of this graph. Now the question comes, how many topological sort are possible for a graph? This is the important question which can be asked in any interview. So what is the answer for this question? The answer is, we can perform any number of topological sort for a given graph, because it doesn't matter. It matters on the graph, like what type of graph is given in the question. Like for in this graph, let's perform the topological sort in different ways. First, we are going to 1, then 2 or 3. We can go to 2 also, we can take 3 also. So the answer can be 1, 2. The default answer was 1 to 6. But if we traverse 3 first, then the answer will be 1, 3, 2, 4, 5, 6. This is also the correct answer for this question. Then after traversing this, we are going to 2. Then from 2, we can go to 4 also, we can go to 5 also. So this also provides another answer. After going 1, 2, 3, we can go to 5 first and then 4. So this is also an answer. Likewise, we can also go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This was the default answer. Instead of going to 5 first, we can go to 4 first. So there are many ways to perform a topological sort in a given graph. So this is the answer for this question. The answer is, we can perform number of operations for finding a topological sort for a graph. Now let's see the time complexity. The time complexity of this question solving in the Khan's algorithm is O of V plus E, where V is the number of vertices and E is the number of edges. This is the time complexity. And the space complexity is O of V, which is the vertices, because we are taking extra space for making the queue. So it is taking V space. So our space complexity is O of V. Now let's see the code. First of all, I am taking two input, V and E. V denotes the vertices, E denotes the edges. I am taking the input and then I am taking a count variable as 0. Because in the algorithm it was given, if the count of the visited nodes is not equal to the number of nodes in the graph, then a topological sort is not possible for that given graph. And it might be a cyclic graph. So we have to also count the number of nodes. Then I am taking the adjacency vector for storing the adjacency list. And then I have made a vector for storing the in-degree and declare it as 0 first. All the nodes as all the vertices as 0. And then I have run a loop till the edges. And I have taken the input u and v. U and v is the edge. I will tell you. See. This was the graph given. And for the input, if we are taking an input, see the edges are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 6 vertices and 7 edges are there in this graph. And the directed edges are 1, 2, 1, 3, 2, 4, 2, 5. Like this, we are going to take input. From 1 to 2, there is an edge. From 1 to 3, there is an edge. From 2 to 4, there is an edge. So for this, I have taken these two inputs, u and v. And I have taken the adjacency list. The edges of the u are pushed. See, we are pushing the v vertices of u in the adjacency list. Like the nodes which are adjacent to a particular node. Like for 1, it is 2 and 3. So we are pushing 2 and 3 for 1s as an adjacency list. Then we are incrementing the in-degree of the vertices. Then I am making a queue and named it as PQ. Then I have taken a loop till V. And we are checking if the in-degree of any vertice is 0, then we are pushing it into the queue as per the algorithm. Then we are checking, while the queue is not empty, we are incrementing the count. We are pushing the first element of the queue inside an element x, and then we are popping the first element from the queue. Like in a queue, deletion operation is done from the starting of the queue. So we are popping it and then we are writing the output in x. Like we are printing the output x. And then I have taken an auto variable it and I am traversing the adjacency list. Then I am decrementing the in-degree. As I told you, we are decrementing the in-degree of the neighboring nodes or the adjacent nodes. And we are checking if the in-degree is 0, then we are pushing it into the queue. And at last, we have to check for cycle. If there is a graph in which a cycle is there, then the topological sorting cannot be performed in that graph. So we are checking the count. If the count is not equal to the vertices, then there exists a cycle in that graph. And then finally, we are printing the count. That is the number of nodes for checking if we have performed the correct operations or not. Let's run the code. First of all, I'll check for cycle. Suppose there are 4 vertices and 3 edges from 1 to 2, 2 to 3 and 3 to 1. It is a cycle, right? See, from 1 to 2, 2 to 3 and 3 to 1, it is a cyclic graph. I have taken the input and then see, there exists a cycle in that graph. The operations cannot be performed. Now let's take the input for a different graph. I have made the graph. See, this is the graph. current code is 52. There is an edge from 5 that is going to 2. From 5 to 2, 5 to 0. 5 to 0. Then 4 to 0, 4 to 1. 4 to 0, 4 to 1. Then 2 to 3 and 3 to 1. 2 to 3 and 3 to 1. It is a directed acyclic graph. Now let's see a topological sort. 5 to 2, 5 to 0. Then 4 to 0, 4 to 1, 2 to 3 and 3 to 1. So this is a topological sort for the given graph. So that's all for this algorithm, Khan's algorithm.